Fellow compatriots, Nigeria is not entirely wrong on border closure. It will earn some respect for Nigerians in West Africa, and I commend Ghana's President, His Excellency Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, for embracing diplomacy to help resolve this border crisis. Fellow compatriots, the Federal Republic of Nigeria has been widely criticized for taking a principled position to stop the smuggling of rice and other forms of contraband from Benin. It is natural that there is always a collateral damage on the chain of ECOWAS countries on the outlying areas towards Benin, including Ghana and Togo. Mine is not to determine whether Benin is right or Nigeria is, and I can't tell which of the two countries is wrong. But of course, Nigeria wants to grow what it eats and eat what it grows. It wants to boost local rice production content by dissuading Vietnamese and Thai rice from flooding the Nigerian market. There are also claims that Nigerian oil is heavily smuggled out of the country through the Beninois border. Only God knows who is right. But from a foreign policy standpoint, this border closure will send a strong message to Africa about how important Nigeria and the good people of that country are. And it also sends a strong message about how pivotal Nigerians are to the survival of the economy of ECOWAS. No doubt, Nigeria has the largest market on this continent, and some estimates even indicate that the revenue generated by Lagos alone is like the GDP of some countries on this continent. Therefore, we can't write off such an important country and its good people. But the sad reality, however, is that Nigerians are treated as pariahs and outcasts on this continent, maybe because of the activities of a few people from such a populous country. And how do you judge a whole population because of the fraudulent activities of a few thousands or even a few tens of thousands? There are good Nigerians and there are bad ones, just as there are good Ghanaians and there are bad ones. Nigerians have been persecuted in South Africa, and in some cases, Nigerian traders have been treated with hostility in the Republic of Ghana, including the closure of their shops. This must end. I commend Ghana's President Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo for opening a diplomatic channel to help resolve this issue. But in the final analysis, this border closure will earn some respect for Nigerians. I urge Ghanaians and all ECOWAS nations to embrace Nigerians and support with the integration process so we all live and work together as one people, Africans. God bless you, and God bless the Republic of Ghana. Thank you.